and welcome to the all-new series of Parkour Video Magazine. I'm your host, Liv Rowlands. In this first episode, we'll be following the UK's very own Neil Hutson as he helps us understand what parkour is all about. We'll be running as fast as we can to catch up with Johnny Budden and report on his 1,000 miles of parkour to Paris. And now, let's find out how our first group of challengers fare in Challenge Team. We have brought our first challengers to Vauxhall in London, so let's meet the team. Ben was first noticed for his acrobatic skill at the early age of 14. After years of fun travelling and challenging himself with friends, Ben is now widely regarded as one of the world's most technically able movers. Daniel has been experimenting with movement from as early as he can remember and is one of the discipline's most influential practitioners, admired by many for his creative thinking and exceptional skill. Phil began training parkour with some of the earliest UK practitioners at the age of 13. Phil's dedication to pushing his limits and passion for movement have seen him develop into one of the sport's most respected leading practitioners. Max was inspired to try parkour in 2005 when a friend showed him a documentary. He's now well recognised for his ability, and when he's not studying acting and music, he enjoys training in London with his friends. So, the first challenge for our team is to go from point A to point B as fast as they can. Okay guys, what are you thinking at the moment then?
Well, Danny's given us quite the legitimate motive.
Yeah, basically, it sounds really silly, but we've decided that the tree that we have to get to at point B is a baby in the tree. And it's about to fall out, and we've pretty much our mission is to save that baby's life. Yeah. So
have you made any route plans already? Kind of ideas of what you're going to do?
Yeah, basically just taking alternative routes and, I don't know, a few in front of the other or depend. Yeah, we're just going to wing it, see how it goes.
After completing their first challenge, we told the team to choose a route from point A to point B that would allow for Phil and Ben to stay off the floor and the outside walls. It soon became obvious that Danny and Max would need to assist them across the space. What our challengers didn't know when they planned their route was that for their final challenge they would have to complete the course in under 1 minute and 30 seconds. Will the team regret deciding to use a slackline? We'll find out in part 2.
The philosophy of parkour is that any obstacle can be overcome. So the method of learning that is you go out and you try and overcome physical obstacles. When you first start, it is just purely a physical thing. You know, you want to try and get over that fence in front of you, or you want to make a jump between two walls. But you learn through doing those movements that any obstacle in life can be overcome with enough effort. I do parkour now because I love it. It's what I live and breathe. Every day when I wake up, first thing I do is think about whether I can go out and train today, look outside, is it wet, who's training, you know, sort of ring people up, see what my body's feeling like. It's more or less all that I think about. I love the family aspect. All my friends are people that train, but the biggest thing for me is the feeling of achievement when I've gone out and had a really good day's training, I've done some new things, I come home feeling fulfilled and really, really happy. I just love it to bits. I first started parkour because I thought it looked cool, and I was really amazed by what the guys that I saw on TV were doing with the bodies, and I never thought it was possible. So I was like, I want to do that. Went out the next day, started training. Feeling of achieving a new movement is great because you've been training for years and years to get to that point in your life. So when you've been trying something over and over, when you first land it, there's an amazing feeling of achievement. Parkour started in the 1980s in a small suburb of Paris called Lys, and it was created by a guy called David Bell, who's the son of a Paris firefighter who was also military trained. And he built up a set of basic techniques that you could use to overcome, you could adapt them to overcome any obstacle that you would find in either a natural or an urban environment. Since I've started training parkour, there's been loads and loads of different benefits that I found from it. I've obviously got a lot stronger, a lot fitter. I can run a lot further than I used to be able to. But there's also some indirect benefits that you wouldn't necessarily associate with a sport or a discipline, such as things like concentration. It's changed my state of mind a lot as well, because it can take you hundreds of times to land something when you're training parkour. It instills a very good mindset when approaching different obstacles and challenges in your life, so I'm definitely a lot more determined. Also, it's a great way to relieve stress for me if I'm really stressed from my everyday life, whether it be work or college, something like that. If I go out and have a good session training parkour, come home and I feel relaxed and recharged again. Parkour is the only activity that I can think of that is the best way to attack obstacles in your life. Say if you're a professional footballer, you'll be really good at playing football, but it doesn't necessarily mean that you'll be really good at having a fulfilled life. So I think parkour differs from other sports and disciplines because it's the most efficient way to overcome problems that you have in everyday life as well as when you're out training.
see the sheep that was like the size of a person down there?
3 days and I've done 5 marathons.
Such an amazing place. The wildlife, like a deer just ran straight across me while I was running. I don't know how long I've been running for, but like...
I've just been running with Johnny, and whilst it's time for me to stop, he's still got a long way to go. What he's doing is for a really great cause, and he could do with your support, so please head over to stickyparkour.com.
When you're training parkour, you don't always land everything that you're trying. You could be trying a movement for a very long time and you still don't get it. So it's very important to remember that the same thing happens in life, whether it be if you're applying for a job and you don't get it, you've got to learn that you're not going to get everything that you want first time. So you've got to stick at it and try and you know, find different ways to get around the problem. Parkour is a very big community aspect. When I first started training, I just did it with friends from school, but since then, as I've continued on my journey and I've sort of come to different places, all of my closest friends now I've met through parkour. It's such a massive community, and it's a real feeling of family when you come to a jam and you meet people you haven't seen for a while. And everyone that I've met through parkour seems to be a really nice, genuine people. So there's definitely a very friendly side to parkour, but it's a very social thing as well. Since I've first started parkour, my training's changed a vast amount. It has a lot of different influences depending on what videos I like at the time, who I've been training with, as well as the weather. So weather is an obstacle as well. If you're training in the wet, you have to make sure that you understand which surface is going to be really slippy, which ones are going to be better to use in the wet. So if you can go to a spot that's undercover, so it's going to be dry, or you can go to somewhere where you know that the surface doesn't react too badly to water, so it's going to grip as well. But it's also, I think it's important to practice doing things to slippery surfaces, because you might have to do it in a real life situation. So if you know how something's going to react when it's soaking wet, then you can try and adapt the technique of the movement so you're not going to slip and hurt yourself. When you first start parkour, it's very important not to get the wrong end of the stick and just go out and start jumping off the highest thing you can find. If you can, I would seek professional tuition, but if you do go out, make sure that you stay low and you're not trying things that are out of your ability. It's really about exploring things that are possible with your own body. So you have to get comfortable with yourself and what you can do. It's really important to be creative. Now that there's loads and loads of people practicing parkour, it's very easy just to take what they do, and instead of exploring what you can do yourself, because there's always new things that can be created. So rather than taking what's already been done, it's very important to find your own path through your training. There's definitely a strength training side to parkour. It's very important to make sure that your body's ready for the things that you want to try. So if you're only doing really basic stuff, then your body's probably already ready for that. But if you're going to be doing landings from height or doing big jumps, and you definitely need to think about doing additional conditioning, which can be done quite easily at home just using your body weight, or if you're slightly more interested, you can go get a gym membership, anything like that. Yeah, I've had quite a lot of accidents. Like, most of them have been little bumps and scrapes, but I've had a couple of more serious ones, like I've broken a toe, and recently this winter I badly bruised both of my feet, which took me over 2 months to get over. But as people say, you do learn from your mistakes, so having small trips and falls is a very important step in your journey through parkour. You have to learn, you know, sort of why you fell. Coping with injury is very difficult, because you can't obviously you can't train properly when you're injured. So I found it very difficult dealing with stress when I was injured, because I really need that release, that physical release of doing parkour. But it's important to, you know, stay focused on the big picture, know that you will get back to full health eventually, and that training on an injury is not going to help you at all. everyone takes something different from parkour. It's there to overcome your problems. It's not, you know, someone else's problems that you're supposed to be battling. It's the things inside you. So it's a very personal discipline. It's something that's not competitive. So you're not trying to, you know, compete against your friend who's got his own problems, because everyone's different. So it's very important to you know, remember that it's about you, not about what someone else is doing.
Welcome to part two of Challenge Team.
We're just going to wing it, see how it goes.
We've just told our challengers they need to complete their route in under 1 minute and 30 seconds. spare, congratulations to our first challenge team. Before we go, remember to support Johnny and donate to Motor Neuron Disease at stickyparkour.com. For more news, information and to buy this episode on DVD, including lots of unseen extras, go to pkvm.co.uk. Remember to subscribe, rate and comment. We appreciate your feedback. Thanks for watching.